In this video, we're going to do the third project in the Arduino starter kit. They call it the Love-O-Meter. Some of the new things in this project is going to be talking about analog signals and how we get analog signals into Arduino, as well as talking about the serial monitor. Let's get to it. The first step of this project is that we're going to actually take off all the wires and components from the last project. As I'm removing stuff from the board, I noticed that I accidentally broke one of my power cables. So in this one, I'm going to have to switch over and use a different wire for that. In the next step, we're going to go ahead and attach our power cables to the rails on the side of the breadboard. So go ahead and find your two wires, plug them into the 5 volts and ground on the Arduino, and then into the plus and minus rails on the breadboard. Talk a little bit more about this in an earlier video, so if you missed that, go check it out. This project, we're going to be using 3 LEDs. The book says to use 3 the same color. I'm actually just going to go ahead and choose different colors. Green one, a yellow one, and a red one. Thought it'd be cool since we're doing temperature to maybe see it go from like an okay green LED to a bad red LED when it gets hot. Let's go ahead and place them on the board. And as we talked about in an earlier video, we need to keep track of the shorter leg and which side that is on. On mine, I'm going to put that towards the top of the board. And the next step, we're going to go ahead and attach the shorter leg of the LED to ground through a 220 ohm resistor. Page 41 of the book has the chart with the different colors of the resistors for you to know what resistance values they are. Go ahead and find 3 of the 220 ohm resistors in your kit. Now what we're going to do is we're going to attach the shorter leg to the ground. So one side of the resistor needs to be put in the same row as the shorter leg, and the other side of the resistor needs to be placed in the rail of the ground cable. Now for the longer leg of the LEDs, we're going to attach that to power, but we want to be able to switch on and off the power so that we can switch on and off the LEDs. So instead of attaching them to the power rail, we're going to attach them to a digital channel on the Arduino. In this case, we're going to do channels 2, 3, and 4. Go ahead and attach each wire from the longer leg of the LED to one of the digital channels on the Arduino. And of course, I went ahead and matched colors of the wires to the color of the LED. When you color code your circuit, it's a lot easier to diagnose and understand what everything's doing, but it's not necessary. Next, we're wanting to place the temperature sensor on the board. So go ahead and look in your kit for this temperature sensor. It's a little bit small. It's got 3 legs coming out of it, and it's got sort of a half moon shape to it. Now the legs are actually pretty close together, so when you're putting it on the board, you're going to have to bend the legs to open it up a little bit to be able to place each one of the legs on its own row. Be careful when you do that. You don't want to break it or break one of the legs off. Before we continue wiring up our circuit, let's chat a little bit about what this temperature sensor is and how it works. And as we do that, you're going to learn a little bit about analog signals and what an analog to digital converter is. The temperature sensor that's included in your Arduino starter kit is the TMP36. The way that it works is that it outputs a voltage that's linear with temperature. That means that as temperature increases, the voltage that it outputs will increase, or as the temperature decreases, the voltage that it outputs would also decrease linearly. So if you look at something like the scale factor, you can see that for every degree C that it goes up, the output voltage will go up 10 millivolts, and for every degree Celsius that it drops in temperature, the voltage will drop by 10 millivolts. To power this sensor, it requires both the ground connection and a positive voltage in the range of 2.7 to 5.5 volts DC. When we plug it into the Arduino, we plug it into the 5 volts DC. Now this temperature sensor is actually able to handle a range of minus 40 degrees Celsius to 125 degrees Celsius. If you go past these limits, you are risking breaking the sensor. If you look here on the left pin or left leg of the flat side is going to be the positive voltage pin. The middle is going to be the output voltage. This is what we're going to be sensing to figure out the temperature. And then the pin on the right is going to be the ground pin. When we think of a digital signals are more like light switches. You can turn them on or you can turn them off. They're either low or high. An analog signal is a range of values. It'd be more like the volume knob of a stereo where you can twist it to adjust the volume. And there's many levels of volume that it could be because it's not simply an on and off. It's a range of values. So let's take a look at how the ADC works with the sensor and how the analog signals play a role in helping us to determine the temperature using the sensor in Arduino. First off, of course, we start with the environment, right? The sensor is inside of an environment that has a particular temperature. In this case, let's go ahead and say 100 degrees Celsius. The way the sensor works is depending on the environmental temperature, it's going to change the voltage that is sensed on that Vout pin. As an example, the sensor might output a voltage such as 4.2 volts. This is the voltage that's going to be provided to the analog to digital converter that's on the Arduino board. Now this analog to digital converter is going to work in what we call counts. It's not going to work in volts. And the reason is that it's going to store this voltage in a certain memory location on the microcontroller. We want to maximize the usage of that memory that we have allocated for this ADC, this analog to digital converter. And so we're going to break up the available voltage that would come into the ADC into equally spaced counts so that we can try and save off what voltage it sees into the memory. So as you see here on the left, I've got a range of voltage from 0 to 5. That would be an example of what might be coming into the ADC. Now, if we have a 2-bit ADC, that means we have 2 bits of memory to store the voltage in. The total possible number of combinations of those 2 bits would be 4. It's 2 raised to the power of the number of bits you have, so 2 raised to the second power. And so what we do is we would space those out, and like I show here, maybe we would have a count of 0 be 0 volts. We have a count of 3 being 5 volts. And since we're wanting to equally space them out, a count of 1 would be 1.6 volts, and a count of 2 would be 3 volts. Now, I chose this because it was a simple example. In reality, the Arduino has a 10-bit ADC. So if we look at the total number of possible combinations of those 10 bits, each bit being either a 0 or a 1, we would see that there are 1,024 available combinations. Those are going to be spaced out equally between our voltage range of 0 to 5. And so a voltage of 4.2 volts will give us a count of 860. You'll notice that the more bits we have, the better resolution we have of our input signal. However, it also requires more memory. Now, for us, we want to, in our code, be able to determine the temperature so we can decide what we want to do with it, which means we first need to get the counts from the memory, and then we need to convert that into our temperature. Now, we can either, like I do here on the left, convert the counts into volts using the scale factor of 5 volts over 1024, and then convert that voltage into a temperature using the scale factor of 1 degree C over 10 millivolts. Of course, we have to take off the offset because 0 volts isn't at 0 degrees Celsius. The other option is that we can convert directly from counts to degrees Celsius without having to convert to voltage first. However, in the code, I believe it's probably going to convert to voltage first, so that's what we're going to stick with. Let's go ahead and start wiring up the temperature sensor. So the left pin or left leg of the flat side of the temperature sensor is where you will attach the power to. The right leg or the right pin is where you attach the ground to, and the center pin is actually what gets connected to the analog channel of the Arduino. We're going to go ahead and choose channel A0. So plug one side of the cable into A0 on the Arduino and the other side into the same row as the middle leg or middle pin. All right, let's go ahead and plug the USB cable in so that we can program it and give the board some power to be able to test it out. All right, so let's go ahead and start the Arduino programming environment. The shortcut looks like this here on the left. The programming environment, the IDE, actually has examples of the code required to run the projects in the starter kit. So let's go ahead and find the one for the project 3. If you click File, then go to Examples, and then down to a Starter Kit. And then if you click P03, it will open some code that you can use for your project. So when you click on that example in the menu, it's going to open up this code here. It is part of the public domain. That means we're allowed to use it without having to worry about any issues. I'm just going to step through the example code with you. And of course, keep in mind, I did not write this code. All right, so the first thing that the code does is that it sets up a variable for the sensor pin. I connected mine to A0, but if you connected your sensor pin to a different number, you might want to change this to whatever value you have it plugged into. Next, it has a baseline room temperature. This is a little low for where I'm at. It probably should have been a bit higher, especially right now during the summertime. This is one way to do the baseline temperature and just see how much it raises or lowers from this point. You could also just sense it down here in the setup portion of the code, and then just make that your baseline. Either way will work. Now this is going to be your room temperature in Celsius. The way that this code basically works is that it tries to see if it's raised a certain number of degrees past the baseline temperature or past the ambient temperature in the room. And depending on how much above that baseline temperature it is, it's either going to turn on one LED or two LEDs or three LEDs. After the few initial variables are declared, we're going to hop into the setup method of the code. This is where you do all your one-time stuff that will be called whenever you reset or start the board for the first time. So the first thing it does is it opens a serial connection to display values. In another slide, I'm going to talk about the serial monitor. Now what's important on this line is that we are able to match up the number that we put here with the serial monitor. The 9600 is the baud rate, which is just a measure of how much data it can send at a time. Now this code did it a little weird. They did a for loop, and for each pass through the loop, they adjusted the pin mode and digital write to the pins. If they were trying to save lines of code, two lines of code for each LED, that would be six lines of code. And if you look here, you've got two comment lines, the four lines of code, and the pin mode and digital write lines of code, that's six lines of code. So they haven't saved the number of lines here, but what they've done is they've introduced more opportunity for issues. So if you got the pin number that you're starting on wrong, or if they maybe got the last pin number wrong, or maybe you didn't put yours all in sequential order, that is going to introduce potential errors in your code, which is why I really do not like that they did this in a for loop. If it was me, I would have just called pin mode three times, once for each LED, and I would have called digital write three times, one for each LED, but it works for now. We can just use it for this project. All right, moving on past the setup method. Now we're hopping down to the loop method. Now this is the code that's going to just continuously run on our board until we either power down or hit the reset button. So let's take a look at what it's doing. Okay, so the first part, read the value on the analog in pin and store it in a variable. As we discussed earlier, the ADC stores a count in a certain memory location. Next couple lines of code are for the serial monitor. Basically, the serial monitor allows us to send messages back so that we can check values as it runs to try and debug stuff. So these two lines here are just that. We're setting up first some text, and then we're going to pass it the value so that later as it runs, we can see that value and just debug or check, make sure it's working right. After we print out the counts to the serial monitor, it looks like we are converting the counts to voltage. The reason that they're using 1024 is because it's a 10-bit sensor. That's 2 raised to the power of 10. If it was a 12-bit sensor, then that 1024 would actually be 2 raised to the power of 12, which is 4096. Now the 5 in that line of code is the voltage. And of course, we've got a couple more things we want to add onto that message, right? We're going to add onto it some text that specifies volts and then pass it the volt value. The next step is to convert from voltage to temperature. As I mentioned, there's a slight offset because 0 voltage is not 0 degrees Celsius. That's what the comment here is specifying. It's saying that that offset is what you need to use since 0 voltage is not 0 degrees Celsius. Now, the reason that the 500 millivolts is 0.5 is because they converted from millivolts to volts. You want to make sure the units are correct. Volts to volts, not volts to millivolts. And of course, it's also going to print out some text and the value of the temperature that it reads out to the serial monitor. And that's going to be the end of here on the left. Now here on the right is where we decide how many LEDs we are going to turn on, depending on how far away we are from that baseline temperature. So right now it's set up that if it's less than the baseline plus 2, it's not going to have anything on. If it's between 2 and 4 above the baseline, it's going to turn 1 on. If it's between 4 and 6, it's going to turn 2 on. And if it's above 6, it's going to turn 3 on. And then there's a delay afterwards. Temperature doesn't change too quickly, so they might have just put that in there to try and smooth out the turning on and off of the LEDs. So this is the end of the code. Seems like it should work. When you're done taking a look at and modifying the code, we're going to go ahead and upload it to our board. Remember, when we try and upload to the board, we need to be plugged in and have the COM specified correctly. But when you do that, you should be able to just upload this straight to the Arduino, and then we can go ahead and test it out. All right, so let's go ahead and make sure that our board is plugged in so it has power, and we're going to go ahead and test out the project. You'll notice that as I start, none of the LEDs are on, and then as I put my finger on the temperature sensor, when you do this, be careful that you do not touch the exposed pins of the temperature sensor. You don't want to shock yourself or anything like that. Being careful, I went ahead and put my fingers on the temperature sensor, and you can see that slowly the lights start lighting up as it heats up a little bit. And then you'll also notice that as I let go, the temperature sensor starts to sense a drop in temperature, and it starts slowly shutting off the lights. Pretty cool. It seems to be working correctly. I did want to have the colors switched with the greens going first and the red going last, but either way it works. So let's go ahead and have a quick discussion on the serial monitor. On the Arduino IDE, if you look on this toolbar all the way to the right, you'll see it looks almost like a little magnifying glass. If you click that, it will open up the serial monitor. I went ahead and just did a screen capture of it for a few seconds as it was running when I was testing out the circuit. Now, as I mentioned before, we want to make sure that we have the correct baud rate on the serial monitor, just to make sure that we're reading in the right amount of data per second. Down here on the bottom right, we need to make sure that our baud rates match. In the code, it uses 9600, so we got to make sure our serial monitor uses 9600. Then I like to click here on the bottom left, the auto scroll, because if not, it will just start running and you have a hard time catching up to the end. Each of the times that I mentioned, hey, we're going to save text or we're going to save a value to the monitor, you'll notice that it was combined and it's on each row. And so that's what's going on here. As the loop just keeps looping and looping and looping and looping, it's reading the values in, calculating temperatures and voltages, and printing it out to the screen and either turning the lights on or off. In the serial monitor, we can see what's happening. We can see the counts, we can see the volts, we can see the degrees. All right, so that's the end of the project. I hope you enjoy the project and are enjoying this series on Arduino. It's really trying to lay the fundamentals down, the basics down, before we start tackling some of the bigger projects in the future. In the meantime, I will see you in the next video.